church office to give me your information. We'll need name, picture, name of school graduated from, and any accomplishments they've had, and their plans after graduation. And the deadline for that will be Tuesday, May 21st. And don't forget to join us at 9:30 every Sunday morning in the fellowship hall for coffee, snacks, and a Bible study. So if you haven't joined us, please come for that when you can.
Tuesday's not May 21st.
What is it?
May 16th.
Yes. Oh, May 16th is the deadline for that. Sorry. Okay. Any other announcements? Marcia.
I wanted to let everyone know that annual conference for the Southern Methodist group is coming up on June the 3rd, 4th, and 5th in Waco. And I'm the lay leader, and there will be probably issues and things that I need to vote on, so I'll be reaching out to many people in this church to ask perhaps your opinion on how to vote. Betty and I will be actively attending, whether it's on Zoom or in person, and there's just some things that we're asked to vote on, and sometimes we have no idea. We have no idea that it was even coming. So we're going to do a better job this year of studying what the issue might be, or just the ideas for new buildings and maintenance, etc. It's routine, but it's still important. And I want to share it with you guys and get some opinions if they're needed. So here it comes. Not too many minutes away.
Thank you, Marcia. Any other announcements? I do have one more. When you said maintenance and building, made me think of the church will be under construction, the education wing, beginning May 22nd, that Monday, and it will last through the week. We'll be replacing the floors. Maureen's mentioned that before, replacing the floors in the education wing. So if you need something, call, don't come. It won't be safe. The church office is part of the construction, so just call us if you need anything that week, okay? All right, if you'll please rise and join us in the affirmation of faith. It's found in your hymnals on page 881. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. On the third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please turn to your hymnal, number 154, All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. We will sing verses 1, 2, 3, and 6, and there will be an interlude between verses 2 and 3.
Oh, have arm today, right? So about 30 to 40% of people have arm today. Something is going on in this community. Lots of people have arm today. Any Jim? If not, let's go to the Lord in our prayer. Lord, you are more than we can say, and you are more than we can comprehend. Lord, right now, we bring our worries, struggles to you in our prayer. Let your healing touch be upon our friends we have lifted before you. Lord, we want to trust you with our hearts. We want to trust you with that problem we are facing now, and we want to trust you for that decision we are going to make this coming week. Lord, we thank you for taking away our anxieties and giving us peace when we pray to you. We make this prayer through Jesus Christ, who taught to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
and crossed the ford of the Jabbok. After he had sent them across the stream, he sent over all his possessions. So Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him until daybreak. When the man saw that he could not overpower him, he touched the socket of Jacob's hip, so that his hip was wrenched as he wrestled with the man. Then the man said, "Let me go, for it is daybreak." But Jacob replied, "I will not let you go unless you bless me." The man asked him, "What is your name?" "Jacob," he answered. Then the man said, "Your name will no longer be Jacob, but Israel, because you have wrestled with God and with humans and have overcome." Jacob said, "Please tell me your name." But he replied, "Why do you ask my name?" Then he blessed him there. So Jacob called the place Peniel, saying, "It is because I saw God face to face, and yet my life was spared." This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
The hymn of preparation is Precious Name, number 536. We'll sing verses 1 through 3. There will be an interlude between verses 2 and 3.
You and I we want some changes in ourselves, right? But we have a bad of frustration about our inability to change things in our life. So we have said, I just cannot change it. This morning, I have some good news for you. If you want to be different, if you want a change in yourself, listen to what God speaks through the Holy Spirit this morning. This morning, we are going to talk about the story of Jacob, which is very familiar with you, right? This story is a wrestling match with God. And it was a turning point in Jacob's life. And this story shows us how our God changes our life. Let's begin with Genesis 32:24-25. Your sermon note number one, right? Let's read it together. Until he cries, "Uncle, I give up." Right? That's the point of wrestling. Have you ever felt like that? Have you ever struggled with something until you are in despair? Until you are in despair? Today's Bible passage says, Jacob struggled all night. It was a long fight, right? Some of you have struggled with an issue for years, right? What's the problem in your life that you are struggling with? Have you ever considered the fact that God is behind your problem? The point is, after our God uses a problem, a difficulty, a crisis to get our attention. Am I right? You know, it is a human nature to put off changes in our life. Most of us say, one of these days, but one of these days never comes. Here's the point I am trying to make. We never change until the pain becomes greater than the fear of change. Would you agree? Would you agree? The mother eagle, she disturbs her child's nest. So it becomes so uncomfortable that the child eagle has to jump out and learn to we never change until the pain becomes greater than the fear of change. The Bible says, Jacob struggled all night. Finally, the pain was so bad that he had to do something. Am I right? Are you with me so far? Okay, let's take a break. I want you to take a deep breath. One more time. Would you grab your bulletin again and join me in Genesis 32:27? Let's read it together. The man asked him, "What is your name?" Jacob. In Bible times, the name you were given was a description of your character. Did you know? Well, you knew that, right? In the Bible, let me repeat it. The Bible, in Bible times, the name you were given was a description of your
character.
Jacob literally means cheer. He was always using people. So he was always getting into trouble. Right? Am I right? When Jacob says, "My name is Jacob," he was admitting who he was. In other words, he was admitting his weaknesses. When Jacob says, "My name is Jacob," it was an act of confession. Get the point? Here's the point I'm trying to make. We will never be able to change our problems all weaknesses until we admit them. Would you agree? So many people hide their problems, their pain behind their job, behind their hobby, behind their possessions. Am I right? So many people do that. When we admit our weaknesses, our problems to God, God gives us His power to change them. Am I right?
Yes.
It is called grace. Right? Let's take a break. I want you to take a deep breath. One more time. You know what bothers me is you go to your grandson's sports day, sports event on Saturdays, and you ask the people, "How are you?" And they say, "I'm fine." They are not. They have some issues. Am I right? They are hiding their pain, their problems behind hobbies, possessions, or career. Would you bring your bulletin again and join me in Genesis 32:26? Would you join me in this passage?
I will not let you go unless you bless me.
Don't you love this passage? Hey, look at me now. Basically, Jacob is saying to God, "God, I have this problem. I am sticking with this issue until I benefit from it." Can you see that in this passage? Can you see that? God, I have a problem. I have been struggling with this issue for years. But I am not giving up until I get something good out of this. Can you see that? Can you see that in this passage? Don't you love his attitude? His attitude is persistent. Right? He is determined to get God's best. Am I right? The fact is, our God often uses a problem to get our attention. But even after God has gotten our attention, God does not solve the problem immediately. Would you agree? God waits for a while to see if we really want it. Here's the problem. I'm getting old. I would like to make some changes in my life. And you want to make some changes too, right? And God wants to make some changes, but it just takes time. It just takes time. Would you grab your bulletin again and join me in Galatians? I think 5:6. Right? Or 6:9. Galatians 6:9. Let's read it together. Let's not become weary. It is the first Sunday of May. You and I, we are going to celebrate Holy Communion. Let's prepare our hearts for communion, sing together one of my favorites. Thank you. I would like to invite everyone to this holy table. Please come. Let's commune with our God. Shall we stand for the closing song? Hey, one more time. Are you ready? I think you can sing better now, right? You know how it goes, okay. Was